Hello guys and welcome to Robert Productions. Today we're going to be going through my tutorial on how I made the Bad Batch trailer. Well, mainly just the behind the scenes, extra footage and stuff that I did to make this amazing trailer the thing it is today. So, let's get into the video without further ado. But before you do that, please make sure you leave a like and subscribe. It is really appreciated, and considering I won't ever be able to monetize my trailers or stop motions because of copyright, I really appreciate if you try to consider joining my Patreon. It's only $3 a month or $1.50 for images, $3 a month for videos, and you get a lot of exclusive content. I've had 2 Patreons join, and I've had them stay on ever since they joined. So that tells you there it's good quality. Anyways, let's get into the video without further ado. So in a lot of scenes where you see something jumping around or doing something, like in this scene right here, there's a lot of work that goes into it. You have to erase around every frame of every person. Here, we have to zoom in. But yeah, you have to erase around every frame to get that clean image. Because if you just erase around the things that are floating around, then it will look way bad and choppy, and it won't match the frame at all. So I had to go in very closely to it and erase each frame with the same picture. I'm not sure if I'm explaining it that well, but you have to go very close to each person. You gotta get in there with your finger. There's no easy way to do this. This is my finger going back and forth across each frame, and it's very complicated. And I have to do the same thing for this with all the ship scenes, everything that's in the air. There's just so many scenes I had to do this for, and it actually hurts your hands after a while. So you have to do it in smaller portions, hence one of the reasons why this took about 3 weeks. And yeah, it just really gives it that nice clean image. Even though it's going for a few seconds, it's still pretty noticeable, and that's just a suggestion I suggest you do, because if you don't do that, then your flying scenes won't look that good, and it'll look like it's standing on something, like some studs, and I just really wanted to give it that clean effect like it's flying in the air. Also, this is in 2x speed. I'm not that fast. So, with this part of the video, you guys always ask me what apps do I use for this, because it looks so great, right? Like, I've got a lot of comments in the comment section, Instagram DMs, all of that, of what do I use. I only use these 4 apps. I use SaberFX, GunFX, Stop Motion Studio, and iMovie. Now, these apps are very good for a lot of things. SaberFX basically does all the lasers. I have a tutorial, well, actually 2 tutorials on my channel already. I'll link them in the info card for sure. I'm not going to forget this time. And for GunFX, that's the explosions and the smoke. So I highly suggest getting those 2 apps. SaberFX is $10, which is a little unfortunate, but you get so much for the value. And GunFX is $5, and you also get a lot for the value. You get a whole different ton of explosions. And again, the tutorials are in the info cards, and you totally should check them out, because I have made them a long time ago, and maybe I'll make new ones one day, but for now, just check those out to see how to do explosions and lightsaber battles and lasers. For this scene right here, all I had to do was basically was mess with the exposure. Now, the exposure part is very useful in a lot of ways. It can change the way of lighting and help green screen a lot in different ways just to make it look more clear, and it's a good thing. And I actually just found out about it in this stop motion. So I tried using it a lot, and it looks amazing for nighttime scenes and all of that. So exposure is in the Stop Motion Studio app that you guys have seen me use for all my stop motions. I don't use anything else. And yeah, so that's how you do lighting. It's not really much of a tip, but just a little tip to help you out. While making this trailer, I just thought it'd be nice if I point out some small details. So this guy has brown hair. So I'll try to make sure that this guy has brown hair and it's pretty accurate torso. And then you also realize this big machinery thing in the back that's yellow. So I try to include that as well. And then you also see this guy right here. Looks like Ki-Ai Mundi. Well, there's Ki-Ai Mundi. And then this guy looks like Thrawn almost. Well, not really, but I mean, he has blue face, purple hair. I don't have any purple hair, so I just did the Thrawn hair. So, yeah, I just like to throw in little things that actually look like the trailer. And then this person's bald. You know, it's just things I do to put the extra effort in. And, yeah, I just hope you guys actually realize that. But, you know, I just really wish I had a second one of these 2 trolls. Well, not 2 trolls, what am I even saying? Regular face 2 clones, because I have one. But the other one's 2 trolls, which is a little unfortunate. But, hey, it's alright, because this guy's $30, and I'm not paying another $30 for another one of these right now. That's insane. So, yeah.
Another bit of detail I included was this Darth Vader's castle. Now, I used another iPhone, that was an old one, as a light, and I just wanted to show this little detail off to see how many people actually noticed it in the stop motion.
With these shots right here, I have the A-wings lined up on little pillars, just like this one. And the way you see the ship angle and turn is by having this tiny little thing right here, and I just move it up a little bit each time for perfect positioning, just to give it that little motion. I wish I could do that with the A-wings, but sadly, I do not have the technology to do that because these things are too light to work with that. So, yeah, it's a little complicated, but still, it's pretty cool how I'm able to make these things work. And then with just a little bit of racing. So, for this scene, where I have all these troopers lined up and we have Hunter and Wrecker in the front here, when we slide across it like that, well, we actually have train tracks. And I made this little assembly literally the last night before I released the film. And something that's a problem was always this bump. So, what I thought I'd do is just make it one piece of track and get rid of the bump that was right here, because it always messed it up every single time. But this way, I can have it at a nice angle and have it be very smooth without being like on a bumpy, studded plate. So there's a little behind the scenes featurette for you guys that I thought would be really cool to share. So now I get why they do it in movies, because it works really good. This scene with the creature, I always want to make sure to include a lot of detail. So for example, right here at the top, I would just shake this around, making Wrecker move away from these things that were constantly moving in each shot. And this way, my hand did a reflection. So if I would have held it like this with my hand instead of having this beam here, then there would have been light flicker, a lot of it, when I was moving my hand around. But since I used this technique right here, there was no light flicker. Also, something else I did was move a little water pose around the water when these things were moving, so that it would give that little bit more of an effect. And I got these water poles from a scare, which this is very dusty underneath here, so I was actually glad that I got to take all these off, because now I can completely dust this and get all this nasty dust out of there. So that was something that was really great and worked out great for me in the trailer. Now this scene right here is probably one of my favorite scenes in the trailer. This scene was not that hard to make, actually. I just had to use a lot of blue screen and a lot of erasing behind it, and yeah, but good thing I got some new world base plates or something just so I could put underneath it, and it can really make the set a lot bigger, you know what I mean? And it looks really good. And there was one little crack in the blue screen, which was a little unfortunate, but I just covered it up with some blue bricks to help it, you know, fit out a little bit more, and I can erase it. It's just going to make my erasing a little bit easier when I'm doing the blue screen. And I was debating whether to put more battle droids or not in this scene, but I decided not to because I didn't really want to overcrowd it. When you overcrowd something, it doesn't look as good. Like, more is not always better, as I've learned from a few Space Doc videos and a few videos like that. If you guys don't know who Space Doc is, he's a great guy. He teaches you guys how to animate battles. Like, not animate, but he talks about what makes a good battle in space and in ground and all that stuff. And it's really quite fascinating. So I thought less was more in this scenario. Also, it's less battle droid arms to move up in. I just thought it would look better in a way. So I just did less battle droids, and I could have added a few more clones. I mean, but I think it was all right. Like over here and right here, I feel like that would have been better, but I really think it turned out great the way it is. So let's get into our next scene.
For this last scene, I actually deleted some footage, so as I'm explaining it in a voiceover. So for this scene, I had to do was make sure to include all the action. So Wrecker lands, he lands on top of a battle droid, shoots the battle droid in front of him, which then shoots the other battle droid that's falling behind them, and then he shoots the battle droid in the front. It's very complicated, and just a lot of detail went into this stop motion. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video. Please check out the trailer and the side-by-side. They look amazing. And my goal is to get 10,000 on the original trailer, just as is, by the time the show is over on Disney Plus. That's the goal. I'm not sure if it's going to happen, but it's just a high goal that I have. So, thank you all for watching this video. I do plan on getting better with these behind the scenes. I know this wasn't the most entertaining video, but I am still starting this series, and I'm not the best at it yet. So, thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Peace out, guys.